Hi, welcome back to another game of Kards, the World War II card game. In today's video, I'm going to be showing a new deck that I'm working on. It's a Japanese-British deck, and what I'm trying to do is use the pinning ability to instantly kill units, along with dealing damage to HQ through the destruction from the Japanese units. So it has a little bit of early rush, as most Japanese decks do have. But then it's also got these like surprise attacks and trying to implement the albacores, what was it, the KI-51 Sonyas, you get the D4Y CCs and the B6N Tenzin. I've also got a Monsoon Rot, which will work with the Desperate Measures and Tora Tora Tora. So there's a few little combinations in this deck that make it quite good at the moment, but there's always room for improvement. Since I only built this last night, I mean, I built the deck about a week ago, or a week or two ago, and it didn't really play very well, so I kind of just stepped away from it for a while and came back to it last night and decided to try again. And I went from rank 3 to rank 1 last night, so hopefully I can get the same kind of wins I got last night and really show how the deck works. Not the greatest hand, but we'll see if we can make it work. The other cool card is this Cromwell. So basically, whenever you destroy an enemy pinned unit, you're going to get a +2 attack. So this can kind of skyrocket if you can get those pinning effects off. Okay, so I'm going to be versing one of those types of decks where they just spam the field with the reserves, the light infantry. So I don't know, I haven't actually versed one of these decks yet, so I don't know how this is going to play out. We do have Desperate Measures and Tora Tora Tora, so that's really good for versing his particular deck. Did you get the double kill there? The problem is that they almost have like infinite card draw, so they can just keep spamming these out. I will bring up the... Cromwell. I was thinking of bringing up the KI-46 and then bringing up a one cost unit as well. Maybe the Cromwell's a better choice. So I can use Desperate Measures now and get some decent value from it. And then I can bring up the KR-46, or I could bring up, I don't really want to waste my pinning effects, so I'll bring up him and get some draw power. I think it's just a deploy effect, so that doesn't really have any value anymore. I still got the Tora 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 as well, so if he does try to spam out more infantry. There. I'm glad he moved that up so I can actually hit that. of signals and the type 43. You must have had some bad luck, because normally those decks will just spam out the light infantry. We've got the KI Sonya, KI 51 Sonya, sorry. So I like bringing these ones out on turn 1 because that way we can still get the bombing runs. And I can bring up the signals as well. Versing this type of deck, last time I versed one of these decks, I lost pretty badly. Because I couldn't deal with all the mobilized units that they kept bringing up, so I could take out a few here and there, but these attacks can escalate pretty quickly. That was a mistake. I actually was meant to use those to kill the honey. The M3A3 honey, but I went for HQ damage instead. Thankfully he didn't have any card draw, so that's very, very lucky. So I can use surprise attack and my bomber to take out the infantry, and then just use air power on the honey. It's probably the best play. Kind of shuts down his draw power combination where he'll heal and buff everything. So I could use the Akita to take this one out and hope that it hits one of these guys, which I think I will do. I can deal the one down. I actually don't have enough to do anything else. I could drop the type 94 TK, then use a surprise attack on this one, finish it off. Might have to do that. I don't have any other options. It's not the best option, but it's the only option. So, surprise attack. We just want to get rid of those cards that can deal all the combos in his deck. So I can use the Albacore to knock out this unit, which I think I will do, and then we'll just get the Muto Regiment up to the front. He does have a lot of mobilized infantry now, but I can deal quite a significant amount of damage to his HQ. These just have mobilized. I might take this out, or I could take out this. Well, I'll need to take out this before I can get 20 of them anyway. Yeah, I think it is best that I remove this. Here we go, I think he's about to get a big bonus in health. Yeah, if I can get the monsoon rod, maybe we could have won that. But yeah, I should have just maybe gone for the honey instead. There probably was a better way I could have played that, but I was just hoping that he didn't have any heals. Or if he did, he only had like the one. Like if he just had that one heal, I should have been okay. But the double honey with the convoy just makes the healing way too strong. I don't like that the front line's exposed against a German deck, but I don't really want to waste my Type 93 either. Yeah, he didn't have anything, that's good. Oh, there's the Monsoon Rot, that could have been useful last game. So I could use Air Superiority to kill that. Seems like a bit of a waste. A weird play. I guess he's just trying to do as much as he can to that. Might as well finish that plane off. Ah, oh, nice. I don't think he's counted his cards properly. That's a nice card, and I bet he's going to use... It doesn't matter, because actually I can do this. So normally you would be able to put the, I can't remember what it's called, an ultra or something, where you can basically, yeah that's it, my nostrum. So you would put that on that other card, on that panther, and when you do put it on that panther, you can then just get crazy amounts of heals and they can't actually target it with units, but luckily for me, I don't have to worry about that. So I could use surprise attack on it and then finish it off, so I might do that because I don't really want that sticking around. And I can just hit face. And get some more card draw. So I could use Air Superiority and then hit him with a Toro Toro Toro, since I already do have the Desperate Measures anyway. there's so many different players I can use.
They seem like the most fun.
I could have just hit him with the fighter and then used desperate measures. I wonder if he's got something for when I move into the front line. Hopefully not. Might as well trade these. So I could... I could drop these and then I kill that. But I mean, using two units to kill one unit isn't exactly ideal. Is this a bomber? Oh, it's a bomber. Never mind. I can just do this. I guess the best play would be, I could use the bombing raid. But I'm thinking I'll just use surprise attack. And just finish it up that way. And just so we can't use stars and stripes, I'll pull that to the front line. I also have the Monsoon Rot Tora 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 combo, so I'm not too worried if he ends up flooding the board. guess now the bombing raid is probably a good time. That's a nice little play. Do I just hit it with my fighter, I guess? I'll just go for face. I could have maybe cleaned up his back line, but it didn't seem very threatening, so I'd rather just hit his HQ. Oh no, see it. So now we can finally use our monsoon rot. Surrender. No, I'm just gonna keep playing. What do we get for the... See if we can hit the HQ. I'm surprised I didn't get hit by Kallus. Okay. I'd rather just push into the front line with those. It kind of forces him to have to kill them by spending a credit. I could have brought up the Mito regiment, but see how he just had to. The only problem is now is that he could have. So I don't mind losing this. Ooh, I do mind losing that though. What about airstrike? Interesting that he would play that card, since he doesn't get any value from it. But he must have a handful of counters, so I'll be a bit careful. Okay. We can get the Mito up though. Losing the convoy wasn't good. I was actually thinking of just using convoy, but I decided against it, since I do want some sort of board presence. The downside is I can't actually kill that yet. I could use air superiority on this, which I think I might do. Oh wait. Oh nice. I mean, it was only going to do one damage anyway, because I didn't have any air support. Okay, this is play. It's turn 7 though, so I can actually. Remove that. Too bad I couldn't use the Cromwell combo with it, but it's not too bad. I don't think I'm going to win this match though, just because I don't have any card draw and he's just gonna keep countering everything I do. I'll try to sacrifice that so I can bring out the Cromwell. It's the thing against these counter decks is that you basically just have to sacrifice units just so that you can use other units, and you normally need some deck draw to be able to sustain that. But at the moment, he's actually taken out my convoy earlier on, so I'm just kind of hoping that I can draw another convoy or a expansion. So I don't want to attack because he's probably got entrenchment again. Sorry, not entrenchment, entrapment or whatever it's called. Yeah, entrapment. So I might just bring up the KI 51 Sonya. And let's leave it at that. That way I can use the bomber to hit first and then the Cromwell. So we can try using this one. Okay, I'm gonna have to use this. Yeah, so that's how you get around those kind of decks. You just keep sacrificing units before. So you sacrifice a weaker unit so that you can play your stronger unit. And you attack with a weaker unit. It's all about knowing like the timing of do you attack on this turn, or do you wait till you have a weaker unit and then use the weaker unit to attack and then use your stronger unit. One thing I don't like doing is bringing up the type 93 up straight away, because if they just use like a bloody sickle or something on it, or if they've got a unit with blitz, then it just feels like you've wasted such a good value card. And I'd rather move these to the front line than play out the Mito Regiment, because I want to be able to start hitting as soon as I can. That's a bit of a pain, because it'll end up bringing up another guard unit. So now I can bring up the Mito Regiment. Oh, nice. I could hit it for 3. I know on turn 7 I can kill it, so maybe I'll just keep pushing and just make it so that he has to go through my units. It probably does have that, like the winter attack, which will probably wipe those out, but... Oh! Nice. That's good value. I don't mind losing that to a hammer. Ah, nice. So bring in another Mito Regiment. And the KI-51. 51, right? Yeah, 51. Because they're still going to be doing 2 damage. So there's a 7, so I could... I might just bring out the signals, and then I'll just do this. So I'm thinking of using like the albacore with the V6N. Looks like he's going for the Manhattan project. Could could do 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. Oh, there's air power, so I can knock out his tank. I got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 damage. Yeah. So 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, I don't have enough. It's interesting that he put that. Oh yeah, that's one. Whenever a friendly unit is destroyed. I guess. Do I bring up the KI-43? I think I should still be okay. Yeah, I still got the egg again. True North. I wonder if that's a Game of Thrones reference. Just wondering if I should keep air power. It is a good card. So this isn't a very good hand. Maybe I should have got rid of air power. Can't even use the albacore because you didn't drop anything. One problem with the deck is that it is very reactive. So if they don't do anything, you do need that early Japanese units that can push up into the front. Oh, very unlucky. I don't have any 8, So if I draw Super Central, I'll be on 9 if I use Convoy, which isn't ideal. But Bombing Raid's not ideal either. I guess I could just use the albacore. Seems like a bit of a waste. Maybe I'll just have to convoy and sacrifice a card. That sounds bad, but oh well. Oh no, because I got one cost, so that's fine. Oh no, it didn't matter because I should have dropped the signals. I'm an idiot. That's right. I wanted to get the combo off with the albacore. No. What a card to lose. Oh well. See, that was the reasoning behind that. And then I was going to drop expansion. But that'll put me back up to 9, so I guess I'll just drop that instead. So a couple of early misplays plus a bad hand. But hopefully we can come back. So I've got the basic sand, but I don't have any of the other cards that run with it. I can use Bombing Raid, deal 3, but then he's just going to get a bunch of heals. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I do have enough to kill it. And it'll use all my credits to do so. It doesn't really seem worth it. I might use expansion. So it's only when he gets attacked, I'm pretty sure. Oh no, it's damage dealt. Okay. I can knock that out now. Ah, so he heals the damage he did. Okay. I thought it was the damage that I dealt to him, but that makes more sense. Let's just take that out. I don't really want to use the combo. I'll just take the front line. See, Honestly, I'd rather use it on something like that. Do I use the SFR already? No. That thing's not too much of a threat at the moment. He could have Stars and Stripes, that'd be a bit painful. I can kill the bomber using air superiority with the Type 93. Oh no, I just need to use. So if I use air superiority on that. Look at the bomber. Nice. So I can kill this, I can kill that. I could also just use air power to kill this. Might be the better option. So I'll use air power. So if I'm Toro Toro Toro, it'd be in a good spot. But I don't have that, so I guess I can do this. Actually, probably should have used the albacore to kill that. And then hope that I hit one of these with the other one. I can pin all his units down if I want, but that's about as much as I can do. Should probably hit the bomber. Don't really want that floating around. I think losing that Desperate Measures at the start just lost me the game, because if I had that with the Monsoon Rot, that would have been a lot more favourable. I could keep this combo and just play it out. I mean, oops, why did I get rid of that? But I don't want to do that. So I can bring out the KR-46 next turn. Oh, okay. See, I don't mind versing these types of decks, because, yeah, I'll do that. I can just use the pinning combo to kill that. There's a second one, he didn't move up to the front line, which is good for me. Do you want to put some pressure on the front line? So I'm just going to drop that and that. So the idea is that I'll use the type 94 with the KR-51. I guess I'm forced to hit this one. And I don't like to bring up the type 93 straight away, because I like to bring it out when I can actually deal damage, so they can't just hit it with a operation. He can basically hit that, and then use for the people to get that. Oh, okay. He did the other one now. Oh, he actually chose to keep. I don't know why he did that. That was a weird play. I might even use the. Actually, I might use air power to kill that. bring up my other file. I don't think he realizes the value of my bomber. Which is good. Problem is that he does have that. I'm just gonna have to pin it, I guess. He's got the final. I probably should have used that to that. Basically the deck. Hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching.